Two pages ranking for the same targeted keyword. Your competitor's page ranks for 10 keywords while your page ranks for 5. So you are missing out on the traffic of the 5 keywords your page is not ranking for. But that could change if you just do a keyword gap analysis, and I'm going to show you how to do it in this video. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress users, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to our channel, subscribe. All right, a keyword gap is the difference between the keywords your competitors are ranking for, but you don't. So identifying keyword gaps helps you discover valuable search terms your competitors are targeting, giving you opportunities to improve your SEO strategy and gain more organic traffic. But the question is, how do you do it? Let's go through the steps. If you run a business or a website, I'm pretty sure at the top of your mind, you already know who your top competitors are. For example, RankMath's top competitors are Yoast, All-in-One SEO, SEO Press, etc. But if you look at the data, your SEO competitors may be different from your business competitors. For example, if you leverage tools like Moz Free Competitor Analysis Tool, this is the link. We have left the same link in the description. Let's analyze rankmath.com. And you will see our top competitors are these sites. These are the top SEO competitors that are ranking for the same keywords as you. While this is one of our main business competitors, the rest are not exactly the same business competitors we thought of. And that's because maybe your top business competitors either do not put focus on SEO, or they are targeting a different set of keywords, or they are a far bigger competitor that you need to catch up to. And that's why doing keyword gap analysis is important, because you can close the gap between your competitors' targeted keywords and yours to uncover untapped traffic opportunities and dominate your competitors if they are underestimating your business. Other than Moz, you can also sign up to SEMrush's free plan to utilize their organic research tool. Enter your business domain and hit search. And you will get a deep analysis on your domain. And right at the bottom, you will see the main competitor's information. This is a visual representation of your competitor's performance against your business. And these are the main organic competitors. And if you click on this, you will see a list of your top 10 organic competitors. Now, just to be clear, the tools we have demonstrated with and will be demonstrating, we are not paid to talk about them. And the links you see in the description, none of them are affiliate links, which means we genuinely believe that those tools will help you out with identifying keyword gaps. No fluff, just pure knowledge. Anyway, once you have identified your main SEO competitors, the next step is to collect keyword data. Now, if you have subscriptions to premium tools like Ahrefs, SEMrush, or whatever, you can basically skip this step. Because for example, if you have the paid version of SEMrush, you could use their keyword gap tool, add your domain name, as well as your competitor's domain. You can add up to 3 competitors. And as you hit compare, you will have a list of keywords your competitors and your site is ranking for. And if you click on the missing tab, these are the keywords your competitors are ranking for, but your site is not. It is a convenient and effective way to do keyword gap analysis. Now, in case you're wondering if there are any free tools to do keyword gap analysis, the answer is there is always a limit to what the tool will show, and you can't get much out of it. So if you don't have the budget for premium tools, here's what you should do. You should use the Google Keyword Planner to extract keywords your competitors are ranking for. If you don't have a Google Ads account, do sign up for it and add your payment information. You don't have to run ads to use the Google Keyword Planner, so it is essentially free. And once you are in the Google Ads account, you can expand the tools, and under planning, you would select Keyword Planner. Following that, you would click on Discover New Keywords, and you would select the Start with a Website option. Now, you can extract the list of keywords your site is ranking for provided by Google Search Console, but for consistency, let's extract here. Let's add rankmath.com. We want the worldwide data, so we will click on the country and remove any selected country or region and click Save. And now all locations will be selected. Select the entire site option and click Get Results. Give it a while, and it will provide you with a list of keywords your site is ranking for. What you want to do next is to download this entire list of keywords by clicking on the download icon right here. If you have Microsoft Excel, it would make sense to download the CSV file. If not, you can export it to Google Sheets, but either way works. Next, you would have to extract the list of keywords your competitors are ranking for. Let's click here and edit the input and hit get results. And now you want to download the competitor keywords. So similarly, let's click on this and download the data, be it CSV or Google Sheets. Of course, if you want to get the keyword data for more competitors, you are free to do so. But for a demonstration, I will just use one competitor. And if you want a tutorial on how to use the Google Keyword Planner to its fullest extent, you can check out this video right here. So now that we have downloaded the keyword data of our site as well as for our competitor, it's time to do the keyword gap analysis to figure out which keywords our site is missing out on while our competitor is thriving with. Alright, to identify keywords your website has missed, you can leverage tools like ChatGPT, Claude, DeepSeek, or whatever. But for this example, I will use ChatGPT. So we are on ChatGPT. Let's first upload the two keyword lists we have downloaded from Google Keyword Planner. And add a simple prompt like, based on the attached CSV files, perform a keyword gap analysis and provide RankMath or your business with a comprehensive list of keywords, SEOability or your competitor is ranking for, but RankMath isn't. Give it a while. Now the output might be different for you, but the key is for us to identify missing keyword opportunities. In our case, it is asking us if we want ChatGPT to generate a downloadable CSV with a list of keywords RankMath is missing. So we will reply with, yes, please generate a downloadable CSV file with missing keywords for RankMath. And here we go. Let's download the file, open it, and these are the keywords. However, there is no search volume. So we will reply with, please include the search volume of each keyword in the downloadable CSV file. Maybe let's include corresponding here. And let's see what it replies with. And here we go. Let's download the file, open it, and now here are all the keywords RankMath is missing out on. Now, if you encounter any limitation issues with the chatbot you're using, such as something like this, then I will recommend that you first sort all the keyword lists you have downloaded from Google Keyword Planner in alphabetical order. And then do the keyword gap analysis with the chatbot in batches. That way you can reduce overlapping as well as reducing errors in missing keywords. And now we have a list of keywords our site can target. But the question is, which keywords should we target first? Because we can't be writing hundreds of content at a time. So let's go to the next step. It is not exactly helpful to have a long list of keywords without more context, so we will go back to the chatbot. Let's say, categorize the keywords in the CSV file into topic clusters based on semantic similarity. Then assign search intent to each keyword, informational, navigational, transactional, and commercial. And finally, organize the output in a table with the following columns, keyword, topic cluster, search intent, suggested content type, and search volume. And let's hit enter or return. Give it a while. And here we go. Let's download the file, open the file, and here we go. We can now sort them based on the topic clusters. But before that, let me open this up with Google Sheets. And now we can sort them accordingly. This is topic cluster 0. If you create one piece of content that revolves around free website audit, you have a chance to rank for all these keywords. And then this set of keywords belong to the same topic cluster. And the same goes for this, as well as this. And out of so many keywords, there are 9 topic clusters. It might be different for your business or website, but based on what I see here, there are only 9 pieces of content to focus on. Now, assuming you have hundreds of topic clusters, you should focus on those that will either provide you with high search volume yet low competition, prioritize keywords that are highly relevant to your business offerings, and focus on keywords with high commercial or how-to intent as they are more likely to convert from traffic to sales. If you need more knowledge about keyword research and how to identify keywords with low competition, you can check out this video right here. Anyway, once you have prioritized your keywords, it's time to start creating the content. The key here is to either create content around missing keywords or enhance existing pages to better target keywords where competitors outrank you. So assuming that we have selected the topic canonical SEO, on your website, you can visit RankMath's Content AI module and use the blog post wizard tool to create content. Since we have decided on a topic, let's skip this step that generates a blog post idea. And then for the topic, we will add canonical SEO. And then if you have done your research, you can add your research and ideas here. Or you can click on this to have the AI generate some ideas. Otherwise, you can also leave this empty, and the AI will brainstorm ideas on its own as well. And then you can select your audience. As you can see, there is a long list of pre-made audiences, and if you don't find a suitable audience, you can always customize it. Say SEO beginners. Hit comma or tab and a tag will be created. And for the focus keyword field, you can refer to your spreadsheet and add relevant keywords so that the generated content will include them. For our case, we can add canonical tag example and canonical links. Hit comma or tab as well, so that a tag will be created for each keyword. As for the tone, you can have a tone or a set of tones that best represents your brand voice. For example, we can have friendly. If you can't find a suitable tone on this list, you can customize it as well, such as approachable, professional, etc. And as for the style, since this is a tutorial style article, we will select tutorial. And maybe I would like to see it as a listicle as well, we will select that. And of course, if you can't find a suitable style in this list, you can always customize it. And then select your language. There are over 28 languages to choose from, but in this example, we will select English. And as we hit generate, it will first produce an outline for the post. And if you are happy with it, you can proceed to ask Content AI to write the post. But if you are not happy with the outline, you can always hit regenerate. But let's hit write post. Give it a while for it to write a long-form high-quality article. And we are done. As you can see, it has written over 1300 words. And this should be the first draft of your article and should not be the final. You should always fact-check and include your input. And if you're happy with the first draft, you can click on Create New Post, and a new post will be created with the content well-formatted. And now we can optimize the content for SEO. So let's first click on the Rank Math tab and include your main focus keyword here. For our case, it will be canonical SEO. And as soon as you have added the main focus keyword, you will see that your content has passed some of the tests. And these tests make up the SEO score. As long as the score is above 80, it tells you that your content is well optimized for the search engines. And if you have trouble fixing any of the tests, there is this Fix with AI button. And when you click on it, it will solve the problem for you. You just have to accept the changes and the issue will be fixed. So give me a while I fix all the issues. And here we go. We have brought the SEO score to above 80, which means that this page is SEO friendly. But now if you want to further increase the chance of ranking your content, you need to optimize it with current data. You can leverage Content AI's research feature. So let's click on the Content AI tab, include your main focus keyword, select the country or region you want to rank your article. And since our target audience is worldwide, we will keep it as is. Let's hit research, and Content AI will scrape top articles ranking for the main focus keyword, analyze the data, and provide you with smart suggestions. As you can see, it has recommended us to write between 2,187 words to over 3,000 words. It has recommended us to add 11 internal links and 3 external links. And as for the heading count, we should reduce the number of H3s and increase the number of H4s, but this is subjective. And also, we should include 2 more images as well as 2 videos. And then it has recommended us to add all these keywords to the content and these keywords to the headings, and also add these related questions to the content. And finally, if you don't know which external links to trust, because linking to sketchy external links can be bad for SEO, you can leverage the links tab and it will give you credible sources to link to. So optimizing your content with current data will give your content a higher chance of ranking for the main focus keyword. And lastly, to further increase the chance that search engines will easily identify and understand your content, you will want to add appropriate schema markup to your page. You can click on the Rank Maths tab, select the schema tab, and as you can see, by default, the article schema is added. If you are a Rank Math Pro user, you can add more than one schema type. So if your content is more than just a simple article, you can click on the schema generator, and here you can select an appropriate schema markup to add to your page. For example, if you are writing an article on Rank Math Review, SEMrush Review, or Ahrefs Review, you can use the software schema and add your review rating to tell search engines what you think about the software. Or if you're writing a physical product review, you can use the product schema. If you want to learn more about each of the schema types, we have created videos on them. Feel free to check them out. The links are in the description. Anyway, that's how you create content to attract your competitors' traffic. The final step of the process is to monitor the progress. So if you have exhausted the list of keywords from one of your competitors, you can always perform the same tasks with other competitors. You also want to regularly track the performance of your newly created or updated content. If you have RankMath Pro installed, you can leverage the analytics module. The SEO performance tab will show you the performance of each page on your site. And if you click on one of the posts, you will discover the keywords the page is ranking for. And then you can also leverage the rank tracker too, to keep track of the performance of the keyword you are targeting. If you have enabled this auto import, the primary focus keyword of your post will be included in the keyword tracking. And if you want to manually add a keyword, you can click on add and add the keyword you want to track and hit save. And a keyword will be added to the tracking list. With this, you can easily track the performance of your keywords. So that's how you can identify keyword gaps between your competitors and your site. And if you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave them in the comments down below. And don't forget to smash the thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. And if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.